Hello friends, let's have a look at these images. What do you think about them? They have a bunch of keys, a school of fish, a group of letters, a pile of books, and a bunch of flowers. The one thing that can be seen in common is that everything is in the form of a group or set. And well, that's our topic for today. Sets. But what exactly is a set? A set can be formed of anything that can be well-defined or distinct. Now, let's see what do we mean by well-defined or distinct. Let's take an example. A set of numbers from 1 to 10. Now, this is well-defined. You can list all these numbers also, right? So, this can be a set. Let's consider another example. A set of smart students or a set of generous people. Can this be considered as a set? No, not exactly, right? Because here, smart or generous cannot be defined or measured. Or we can say that these are relative terms because the meaning of these words will change from individual to individual. Hence, we cannot make a set of these situations. Let's take a simpler example. A set of all the letters that comes after T. So what all letters will be there? U, V, W, X, Y, and Z. Yes, so this can be also called as a set, right? Let's see a few of these examples if we can form a set of them or not. The first is States of India. So can we form a set of this? Yes. Because there are 29 states in India and you can list all of them. The second one is strong students in a class. Well, this cannot be a set because strong is a relative term. But suppose here if I'll add a condition like students who weigh more than 50 kg in a class are to be considered as strong. Can now this be formed a set? Yes, because now we have a number, a quantity, or a well-defined and distinct property that we can use and form this set. Right? Let's see the next one. Students who have scored 70% and above in the last semester? Yes, you can form a set of this. Collection of great people in the world. Again, great is a relative term. And we cannot form a set of this. So I hope by now you know what are sets and in which conditions we can form a set and cannot form a set. Let's move to the next step. So how do we present these sets? There are two different ways to write these sets. One is listing method or also known as roster method. The second is rule method or known as set builder method. Let's see what's listing or roster method is. If I want a set of all letters in the word mathematics, then how will I write it? Well, this is a very simple method. Let's look at this in a little more detail. All the letters in the brace or curly brackets are known as elements. A or any letter can be used to represent this set. However, there's one tiny mistake that is there in this set. The elements in this set are never repeated. Every element appears just once in a set. Hence, the solution of the set of all the letters in the word mathematics will be A is equal to curly brackets M A T H E I C S. Curly brackets closed. This is how we present a set in a roster method or a listing method. Now, since just we have listed all the letters, is the reason why it is known as a listing method. Next can be a set of all the days in a week, a set of all the rainbow colors, etc. We have also been studying sets in few of our previous grades. It's just that we never knew that they are sets, like a set of natural numbers, a set of whole numbers, a set of integers, etc. Sets are used in a variety of places in mathematics, but we'll see that in the future sessions. So now I believe you can make any set using the listing method. Now what happens if I ask you to form a set of all the whole numbers between 0 to 10,000? Can we use this listing or roster method to list all these whole numbers till 10,000? No, right? Hence, we have this rule method or set builder method. Now, since we are building a particular set, instead of writing all the elements in the set, this is known as a set builder method. Now, a set using set builder method is written like this and is read as: A is a set of all x such that x belongs to whole numbers and x is a whole number between 0 to 10,000. Now, was this a little difficult? Let's try another set. Now, can we represent the set of all letters in a word mathematics in the form of a set builder form? Well, yes. Let's name this set as B. B is a set of all x such that x is the letter of the word mathematics. Every set can be represented in the set builder form. Try a few of these sets in the form of listing as well as set builder method. Now, why this method is known as a rule method? Now, here we can see that we have added certain conditions in this set. This is the reason why this is also known as a rule method. So, till now we have seen that what is a set, things that can form a set, and ways to represent these sets. In our coming sessions, we will see what are the different type of sets and also about the Venn diagrams. I hope this session was useful to you. If you have liked this session, please hit the like button. Do comment down your queries and don't forget to subscribe our channel. And don't forget to hit the bell icon and never miss another update from Let's Tute. Till then, keep watching, keep learning. Thank you.